really quick. There you go. Yeah, this is going to be
game two in this best of three.
Yeah, this is going to be an interesting matchup here. I haven't seen Train in a while.
One more game for Rekka, and they win the series.
Yeah, and Mineski will get eliminated. Remember, this is a best of three. This is an elimination. Once you go out, there's no lower bracket to save you there.
And, yeah, again, this they're fighting for the Southeast Asian qualifier. Yeah.
Southeast Asian spot for Zen League, which is going to be in Australia. It's going to be an online tournament. And the winner of this will be... flying to Australia in order to compete with the Australian teams and with better pings, so. But, yeah.
G gonna be charging in here. He's gonna be spotting out Rousseau. He is the raid boss for Mineski. Spots out Bentet and shuts him down. So only Frost Misty in a 1v4, and G is still so difficult to kill right there. And Frost Misty's like, you know what? Just give me G. I just want G. But, you know.
No, Retract. No. Retract's gonna have to take the kill. He doesn't want to get this. He doesn't want G to get all the flame, the fame and glory.
Yeah, the fame and fortune.
Fame and fortune. But, yeah. This is... this is the second game, for those of you who are asking, this is map 2 of the best of 3 series.
So XP going to be playing with a Deagle, forcing right off the bat, is he going to come out of Ivy and just, you know, blast the guns ablazing with a one-hit Deagle?
And, yeah, Expert with the Deagle, he's been pretty deadly in the past round. Give him the Deagle, he's going to make sure all the shots count.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
And they're saying here that Train is actually Rekka's home.
Train is Rekka's home. Wow. That's a big word to say. We'll see what's going to happen here. Mineski right now is just chilling at the back. They are going in for A push here, but Rekka able to take two guys off of Mineski's roster there. It's now down to a 3v4 situation. Still anybody's game. Retract, it might get taken off guard there. A couple of shots are getting fired right now. Gee takes down Super Assist off camera there, and the push onto A is now happening. Bentet takes down Retract at the ladder to Pop Dog, yeah.
As he was trying to maybe provide some support for Mineski.
And Gee able to take down X-Script there. It's now the 2v2 situation. The momentum is no. Beautiful shot there from Gee. Now up to Frost Misty and see if he can clutch this. They don't know where Frost Misty is. They're not looking. This is going to be huge. He knows somebody's there at Ladder Room. He's going to try to see if he can get another information there. He doesn't spot out Dubstep. Oh, wow. This is nice. But no, Gee takes down Frost Misty. Mineski in the lead with 2-0.
He was hoping to actually get Gee, but then Gee was actually on the right side, the safe side, I think, of heaven there. It was just a rock paper scissors thing. He didn't guess right on where Gee was specifically positioned there. If he did, that would have been a ninja kill and AK-47 to steal, and then a 1v1 situation would have been more in favor for Frost Misty.
Yeah, he has the high ground advantage there. He'll be able to spot
that as well.
But all that thought, Retract taking down Rousseau. A couple of shots getting fired here. Dispenser and Dubstep cleaning up Rekka Esports. Yeah, Super Sis and Frost Missy on their own. Super Sis is going to try to see if he can get the kill. But no, that's not going to happen. Dispenser takes out Super Sis. It's just Frost Missy on his own. Going to try to get some pop shots there. But no, Dispenser takes him down. Mineski still in the lead with 3-0. And Mineski is feeling the rush now. I think this is going to be revenge.
Revenge indeed. But at the same time, you can't pull out Rekka Esports yet, because you know what happened a while ago? 10-5. And they were able to come back into a 16-14.
16-14 scoreline. I mean, that's a tall order to do for a team.
And you have to take note. Mineski were the ones to pick Cobblestone. This is the map for
Rekka Esports. Yeah. Hold that thought. Dispenser able to take down the Super Sis there. A couple of shots getting fired. Bentet takes down Gee. And Bentet takes another one before getting taken down by Adrian. It's now down to a 3v3 situation. Mineski is in low HP. And Dispenser taking out Rizzo. Everything's going to play slow right now. Mineski needs to play slow here. They are incredibly low. And ooh, Extrid almost getting Dispenser there. Dispenser just hopping around, trying to be a bunny, and the bomb has been planted. Adrian, good one on you on getting that bomb plant, and still anybody's game at this point.
But at the same time, Mineski's duo right now are on dire straits in terms of the HP. They find Dispenser right there. He's gonna charge in and spot a jumping Extrid, but at the same time, Frost Misty was fast on the trigger, finding Adrian right there, who has killed his fallen comrade, and now they're gonna be able to get their first point of this second map.
And wow, Rekka Esports in this gun round are showing that this isn't just their, you know, this is their map. They picked this. Of course, I'm gonna give a shout out to Yao from AC Gaming. Happy birthday to you. It's from Reese. Ekoi.
Yes. And of course, shout outs to our viewers right now who are tuning in. Still strong with the 600 amount of viewership. Thank you so much for your support, guys. And hopefully your team does win, be it Mineski, be it Rekka, because you know what? We all love CSGO. Dubstep gonna be coming in from a long, pushing up into Ivy, but he's very cautious right now because this area right here is so open. There's no real avenue where he can find a cover to actually back off when he gets pop flashed in. So he has to run all the way back to that back alley area right there. And you know who is waiting at the edge of this Ivy? It's going to be Extrid with the AWP.
Yeah, everybody's just playing chill right now. Rekka Esports, they have money to play with in the next round, but you know, it's still gonna depend on Mineski at this point. They still don't know where to push. They still haven't found an opening yet, and you're just waiting on Rekka to
On Rekka to actually go get kills on their members, or Rekka to actually go aggressive on them on these off angles.
And these off angles are actually working in favor of
G's already on the site, spots out Ventet, but he will not win. And Frost Misty riding behind the train right there gets the kill. But now Mineski have also done the loop around. They're actually going to be pushing for the A site, and they get the kill onto Ventet. Now only Frost Misty remains with an M4A1, as well as, well, he does have the defuse kit. So if Adrian peeks this one and Frost Misty does get the kill.
Yeah. And it's just Frost Misty on his own. He'll be able to clutch this if he plays it smart. It's just a cat and mouse game at this point. I'm going to try to see if he can get as much information as he can before he starts acting. And right now, he's not getting any information. He's not seeing anybody from Mineski at this point. But all that thought, he actually takes down Adrian. Going to try to see. He takes down Dubstep. It's now down to a 1v1 situation. Retrack on his own. And he's just going to go and save that AWP. Good on Rekka Esports for that.
And now he's at the edge of A long. He could actually get the kill onto a Retract, who might be looking right at him, and he does. Well, they're going for the 1v1 though.
Going for the 1v1, but it's not gonna be enough. But yeah, Mineski is still in the lead. Of course, for those of you tuning in right now, share the stream link. It's twitch.tv/MineskiInternational, and you are watching The Shootout Season 3, powered by Mixbot.
Yes. And again, guys, this is the second map, not the first. We've already played Cobblestone, and the one who won that was Rekka.
Rekka Esports, yeah. 16-14 scoreline was a pretty close match, to be honest. Well, hold that thought. Frost Misty going pretty aggressive there. Adrian takes him out. The damage has been done. 4v4 situation, and beautiful shot there by Excurate. That op shot is on point, man.
And now he's going to be climbing up onto Heaven and maybe looking for a different angle here, but look at this super assist. Actually, never mind. I thought it was right at the right where G and the other remaining members of Mineski are looking for that flank maneuver, maybe just to choke them off or to strangle their positioning.
But I don't know. It's still pretty much anybody's game because they can still... They could actually wrap around Mineski at this point if they choose to, but they're opting to just play it safe. They don't have enough guns to work with here. Just two USPs, a 5.7, oh, no, I'm sorry, a P250, and an AWP there on the X-Curate. It's it's not gonna be good for them to go on for the rush. I mean, I think
yeah,
they just
but at the same time, Dispenser is already lurking here. If you can get the kill onto Excrete, this will make it so much easier for Maneski.
Yeah, and we are seeing the rush here. Dispenser very sneaky there, taking that Rousseau. Extra takedown, Adrian gonna go for the no-scope, but that's not gonna happen. It's now down to a 2v2 situation. Maneski has the upper hand here. They are in the side, but Pentet almost takes down Dispenser, but it's not gonna be enough. The bomb is gonna get planted. Super Saiyan on his own. Let's see if he can clutch this. It's not gonna be enough. Gee takes him out. It's now 5-1 in favor of Maneski. Maneski is now... They have the momentum. They must be feeling good right now.
They actually are, because... You saw there, Super Sis kind of missed a lot of taps on that P250, and it could have been worse there for Maneski. Even if he only was on that P250, he was in the range where he was already almost lethal.
Almost lethal indeed.
Or yeah, close to lethal, one hit taps.
If his shots were on point, that would have been so good. All that thought. It's a 3v1 situation. Excrete on the stone with that MAC-10. With that MAC-10. And it's a 2v1 situation. Maneski is now going to rotate to B. Excrete is behind them. They don't know. Oh, they know. The Molotov is going to stop them. This is going to be an easy round for Maneski if they play it safe.
Yeah, now they're looking for the fight. Or he's looking for the fight. He's going to be pushing through the smoke. They didn't have the angle on the X-ray.
And Dubstep cleans it out. And they have 1-6 in favor of Maneski. This is the comeback that they need. This is a momentum that they need, the confidence booster they need. Pretty sure their confidence were wrecked by Rekka. Hey, pun. Earlier on.
Yeah, now Rekka Esports are going to be able to buy up yet again. The problem is... after this one, if they lose this, they're gonna be forced to at least go for one round or two rounds of eco. Ross Misty super aggressive, gonna spot out Retract there and gonna exit out. But he is flashed, too much flashing onto Ross Misty. And he was blind the whole duration of his life on this 8th round. Now Adrian is gonna burn to the flames, spots out G, and Bentet is cleaning up house. Now only Dubstep remains, but they know he's up on heaven right there. He does get the kill on Bentet through the smoke, through the flash as well, but the defuse is happening right now. Dubstep spotted out by Excrete there, and now Rekka Esports able to defend, and now they will get that 2-6 scoreline.
And there you go. Rekka is now slowly catching up here. I think they are starting to bounce back, and just, which is actually, which makes our job pretty intense at this point. 2-6, fully bought, both teams fully bought right now. Except for Frost Misty, going for the FAMAS instead of the M4. Oh yeah, his money isn't
enough.
Isn't enough for
actually this. He has 150 left, so maybe that's just... you know, that being a little bit safe on economy, I guess. At least if they lose this round, they can buy a Deagle possibly to their next round.
Yeah, and Excrete, I'm going to try to see if he can go for the hot shots there. And Rekka Esports cleaning up house, takes down two guys from Maneski. It's now down to a 5v3 situation. Still nothing much happening here. At this point, Maneski is still hanging back. Still waiting for an opening. And I think they are leaning towards going for an 8-8.
Excrete was timing that up through the smoke, but through the flash rider, didn't connect for him.
And he's just holding that angle so aggressively. Still anybody's ball game at this point. Excrete just waiting for the smoke to clear. Dubstep is in an off angle, and yeah, nothing much is happening.
Even if. You see that that the previous map on Cobblestone was 16-14. They're voting for a lot of the people who are watching right now, 80% for Rekka Esports, so the 20% of Maneski. So, you know what? It just goes to show that it's not all about the voting as well. I mean, it could be right because people do, some people do watch these teams very closely. But at the same time, there are these upsets. Even if Mineski did lose, it was still a very close match. But now Dubstep spawning out, Excurt there, but not gonna be enough. He gets taken down by Frost Misty, and that AWP will be safely given to the hands again of Excurt.
And wow, 3-6. Rekka is now catching up to the scoreline. What is going to happen here? They still have money. They force out Mineski. They force out the pistols from Mineski here. It's a couple of P250s, and Mineski is actually gonna be a full-on A take here. Split to A. Gee's gonna wrap around to B. He's gonna try to see if there's. They're just trying to make sure there are no stranglers there. Oh wait, it's actually going to be a B push. Shots fired from Rekka. Just going to try to see if they can get somebody through the wallbang. And Frost Misty is going to be the first person that's going to find out if... this is going to find out that Mineski is going to push here. No, he hasn't spotted the bomb. So the rotate's not coming in from Rekka just yet. And Mineski is still hanging a bit back. Just waiting for a response here from Rekka. And wow. Nothing... I mean, they need to decide. Are they gonna go for A or are they gonna go for B? Dispenser is actually behind, they're going in for the lurks here as the moment.
Yeah, but Rekka are playing a very close, tight, coordinated positioning. You can see there, if Supersys and Excrit go down, there's always Rousseau to give some support, and there's gonna be an enabled fast rotation coming in from Frost Misty as well as Bentet. If ever, it's going to be a full-blown A take here by Mineski. So I do really like this positioning. Nobody is at B long or anything. Now, they're going to go. Nice headshot there from G, but then they have lost a lot of their comrades for this one. And Supersys is having a spray down, mow down.
It's just retrack on its own. A 1v3 situation. He's not going to survive this.
And he wasn't even able to plant down that bomb. So Mineski... they really wanted to get that one, so maybe they could have had enough money to buy AWP possibly and even more utility here, but they have to do with what they have because Rekka are starting to again take control of this map. And well, they don't have an insane amount of money, but they can still draw for their teammates if ever they lose this one.
Yeah, they'll still be able to clear around the economy. They just need to hit smart, you know. But yeah, Rousseau actually takes down Gi off camera. Supersys takes down Dubstep. It's actually gonna it's slowly being a wipe here from Rekka, taking down three guys from Mineski. It's now a 3v2 situation. Still anybody's ball game. Dispenser. Oh, the angle being held there by Benta, but it's not gonna be enough. It's now a 2v2 situation. Dispenser and Retrack are going to go for an A take. It's just Excurate on his own. The rotate is now coming from him, and we'll see if he'll be able to clutch this. Not much happening at this standpoint. We'll try to see if he can get the shot onto Dispenser, but no, Dispenser is the fastest trigger in the Southeast Asia. 7-4 in favor of Mineski. But yeah, Rekka Esports right now, they are going in for a full save. They have money to buy each other guns. They're just dropping pistols for their teammates, but aside from that, they won't be able to do much damage to Mineski unless they get caught off guard here.
So they're still looking to actually get that AWP possibly into their next round.
Yeah, they're gonna look to see if Mineski would be able to, you know, get. If they will be able to do some economical damage here to Mineski, that's going to be big. Mineski doesn't have enough money to work with in the next round if they lose, so losing that AWP, losing that AK-47, that's going to be a huge factor here. And Mineski is hanging a bit back here. Rousseau just guarding A side just in case somebody spots, just in case somebody goes in. But yep, pretty much still anybody's ball game. And here we go. Rousseau actually wasn't able to see Adrian here. He gets flashed out. Dispenser and the rest of the Mineski squad are now going to go in for an A-take. Rousseau going to try to see if he takes down Adrian. He actually takes him down. He's now down to a 4v3 situation. Rizzo still trying to get the picks, but he's trying to get taken down. McGee.
Weak that pick to 50, but that's not going to be enough. Bentet here at the edge does have at least a season 75 and some armor to work with. But as he drops down, Dispenser is waiting to give him his death card. He goes down and 8-4 is going to be our scoreline here with Mineski. Looking to come away with somewhat of a strong lead in this first half.
Yeah, I mean, things might change on the second half. Rekka might be better at their T side rather than the CT side, but I've seen Mineski play Train before. Their CT side is solid in Train, but we'll see if Rekka will be able to answer. But Dubstep taking down Excurate as soon as he sees him. And it's down, quickly down to a 5v4 situation. Adrian gonna get the pick at Super Sis. Gonna go for another one. Takes down Rizzo. Now down to a 4v1 situation as Dispenser takes down Bentet. Just Frost missing on his own. Gonna try to see if he can go for the retake. And Dispenser almost goes down, but no, that's gonna be a headshot. That round only took 30 seconds. Brought to you by Mixbot.
Insane fast round for Mineski. And almost on to our last round of the first half. Well, I'm curious to see how Rekka Esports, I mean, they've shown such strong showings when they are on CT side, but even stronger on their T side. So I want to see what happens when they are on that defensive side of the coin here.
Mineski kind of screwing up their rush there. And this is going to be a full-on B-take. They know that Rekka Esports doesn't have much to work here with pistols on their disposal. And just extra it on his own, it's not going to be enough. 3v1, he goes down. 10-4. We are on the last round of the first half now, ladies and gentlemen.
This could be deja vu. I'm looking at Rekka Esports to actually win this one. 10-5, and then what happens again is another 16-14.
That may happen. That's hindi siya malabo.
It's not impossible.
It's not impossible. It's still gonna happen. But yeah, Rekka Esports now with the utilities, they just need to make Rekka Esports need to make use of their utilities properly here. They have the flashes, they have the Molotovs, they can delay the plant, they can delay the pushes here. They just need to make use of your utilities properly there. But off-camera, Excurate and Dubstep actually going in for the trade. Bented with the backstab onto Retract. It's out quickly down to a 4v3 situation, but the bomb is still nowhere to be found here. And Rizzo takes down Gi. It's Dispenser and Dubstep versus the world 2v4 situation. They still have time to play here. They can still find an opening. They're just gonna need to play it smart. They have smokes, they have flashes. They'll be able to at least get the bomb plant, but we'll see. We'll see how Rekka reacts here.
Rekka definitely can have an upper hand, and it looks like my prediction was right. 5-10, baby. Unless Dispenser can go for the clutch.
Yeah, but Benta taking down Dubstep, and Dispenser is just playing it chill. The bomb is now in the hands of Rekka, and Bentet is the only person guarding there, but he doesn't know where Dispenser is.
No, he spots out Bentet there.
He sees the gun. Dispenser gonna try to make sure that he can get the gun, but no, why didn't you take the shot, Dispenser? Bentet closes out the round, 5-10. Good half.
Well, to be fair, Dispenser kind of wanted to get the one kill before killing Bentet. Even if he actually wins that initial fight against Bentet, he was already still kind of enclosed in every single member of Rekka Esports surrounding his area. So he needed at least a way out. And after he kills Bentet and had one person, he could still get the bomb plant down.
Yeah, but Dispenser doesn't know that the rest of Rekka were in what's that called outside Ivy?
A-long,
yeah.
Yeah, but still, there was this one man on B side itself. He heard him already.
Yeah, he was just looking for a way to like go for another frag there.
Yeah, exactly that one. But then he kind of gets spotted out by Bentet, and it kind of backfired.
Prematurely, he spotted. Yeah.
But you saw what he was thinking there. It was actually almost nice if he could have done it. That would have been a great highlight reel for him.
Yeah, that's gonna be one for the highlights, but hold that thought. This is now a firefight 4v3 situation. Mineski is shambling right now with their CT side. I don't know what's going on here. Rekka cleans up the board. It's now 6-10 in favor of Mineski, but Rekka gets a pistol round. They'll be able to buy up the SMGs, possibly go in for the rush.
And that's definitely gonna be around 2-3 free rounds for Rekka Esports. Mineski are gonna be forced are gonna be eco buying into this round with 3 deagles, P50 and 2 nades, so maybe they're gonna nade stack A main.
And the nade stack is coming in right now. But, you know, Dispenser still has the nade. Gonna go see if he can get the initial damage here. But Rousseau takes down Retract. Dispenser takes down Extra and E. Bentet takes down Adrian. It's just back and forth. Mineski is slow, dropping down like a sack of potatoes. And Gee is down 2 HP. He's just gonna run away. Walk. Hide. The hunt is on for Rekka. It's just Gee on his own. I mean, it's gonna be a miracle if Gee takes someone out from Rekka. It's gonna be a miracle. With 2 HP, even a hit from a flashbang is gonna kill him.
I think that one damage.
I take that back. 2 hits from a flashbang, but
oh, he could have
almost, but it's never around. Enough.
Not enough.
Well, yeah, 7-10. Rekka Esports is now climbing the ladder. They're catching up to Mineski right now with 7-10 on the board.
And Mineski are going to be forced to go for another eco here. Definitely on the next round they will be able to buy, but that scoreline is getting closer and closer, and we are looking for another deja vu moment here.
Yeah, this is going to be too close for comfort for Mineski. 7-10. Rekka slowly catching up. They don't have much to do here, and Frost Smith, he takes down Dispenser, gets Gee, gets another one there. He is on fire right now. The Flame of Rekka! I said it.
Yeah.
I did it. I said that, the Flame of Rekka.
That was supposed to be me, man.
but I said
it. Yeah, but still, do you have to give it to Rekka for, you know, getting that initial pistol round on their T side? That was a huge possibility of comeback for them, and it's now allowing to get all of these rounds, all of this cash, so that even if they lose the first buy round or the first gun round for Mineski on the second half, they're still gonna be able to have more money to work with. And Adrian was about to do a 180, but Bentet was too fast on the trigger and he goes down, and now Rekka Esports are playing around 5,000 cash right now.
Yeah.
Or sorry, 6,000-7,000 cash right now.
For those of you asking in the chat, this is a Southeast Asia qualifier for Zen League. Rekka is from Indonesia and Mineski is from the Philippines.
Fake Poland.
Fake Poland. Oh wow, don't say that. Don't say that on. Come
yeah.
On.
There's no such thing, guys.
I mean, you can just flip the flag, it's Poland. So I think that's where it came from, so. But yeah, it's a pretty crazy buy here from Rekka. 2 UMPs, sticking with the UMPs with the SMGs that they have in the earlier round, and Mineski with a partial buy with just the utilities, and they're making good use of the utilities. But Rekka has the upper hand here. They're dictating the tempo at this point. Mineski doesn't know how to answer, and oh my God, Dispenser. He's gonna find out about Bentet and Rousseau, and he backs off, straying away from the fire that Bentet is spitting right now, spitting straight fire.
Super Sis is right at the edge of the smoke, but he kind of overcommitted to that one, and Adrian gets himself a double kill, making too much noise, and the sharp ears of this player will hear you out. Extra is going to be charging in with a MAC-10. He spots out Adrian, but not going to be enough, and Adrian bags himself 3 kills. And Rekka Esports, they were actually playing with just SMGs.
And it's now 11-8 in favor of Mineski. Mineski, now they have all the fully stacked utilities here, and Rekka, they don't have much to work with here. Oh, wait, they are actually going in for the full utility buys, except for Xcurate going in instead for the op and a single flashback.
They actually had a lot of money. looking at it, because they were around what, 8,000?
Yeah.
And they just played that previous round with the weapons that they had when they bought up. They didn't upgrade their weapons.
Yeah, they didn't upgrade their weapons. They actually bought some of them weapons there, but nonetheless, Mineski and Brekka, they are shooting. Gonna try to see if they can go for the pre-fires and the boost coming in for X-Creator. Gonna try to see if he can see someone from the on top of the trains. And still pretty passive. Nothing much is happening here. Ooh, a beautiful shot coming in from X-Creator. They're taking out Dispenser. Let's have a look at Bentet actually, real quick. Bentet is at IV. Gonna actually the lurker here. Gonna try to see if he can catch somebody off guard, but he's not pushing just yet. And oh, there you go. The push is now coming. Dubstep is in the corner. He doesn't know it. He doesn't know it just yet. Dubstep doesn't know that Bentet is there at IV as well. And the take is now coming in from Rekka Esports. Bentet takes down Dubstep. Supersys takes down Adrian. It's now down to a 5v2 situation. Retract goes down. It's a 5v1. Gee is just gonna have to run away. Save that M4.
Yeah, and it has pretty Bowie knife, but aside from that, Rekka Esports able to get the ball plant yet again. But Mineski do have money to work with. Losing this round will allow them to actually buy up into that next round.
Buy up into the next round. But yeah, 8-11 scoreboard. It's gonna be a 9-11 scoreboard. Bentet sees Gi and it's gonna be good. It's gonna be good for Rekka.
Alright, I'm gonna say it immediately, guys. I'm sorry for that one. I didn't mean it as a insult. I didn't even know what it meant. But yeah. Now that was my bad.
Yeah, just a word of advice. Whatever you see on chat, just don't read it back.
Yeah, I was reading.
Unless you're pretty sure that it's not going to be offensive.
All right.
We are sorry, guys. We apologize for the for what Darwill said.
Asurai, bro.
Asurai said. Who's Darwill? But yeah, it's a 1v3 situation. Gi on his own with that 5-7. He's not going to be able to do much. He's just trying to see if he can scavenge some weapons there, but wait, hold that thought. Gi is actually slowly sneaking in. Gi is sneaking in, able to get the kill onto Supersys. Oh, wait, he's gonna try to see if he can get the ninja, but it's not gonna happen.
He's playing peekaboo with Frostmisty on that electric box, but does not win the duel, and even gets an AWP for Bentet or X-Curate. They're gonna give it to X-Curate.
Yeah, X-Curate gets the kill. It's now 10-11.
Oh my. So only 6 more rounds before Rekka Esports win this best of 3, or 5 more rounds and Mineski push this into a third map.
And we are going to see if a third map is indeed going to happen. And the third map will be interesting. Mirage, undeniably Mineski's best map. We'll see if Mineski will be able to get this game. We'll find out if, you know, Rekka can find an answer.
Adrian with the headshot onto Rousseau, and now G at the edge of that smoke actually getting the kill onto Bentet, so that's going to make it into a 2v4 with only X-Grid on that op and Supersys on the rifle to remain. So we'll just see if they're going to be pushing on to a site. Actually, it's going to be it, but at the same time, Adrian was waiting at the point itself, and he doesn't get the kill. Supersys now spotted out by Dispenser. Dispenser trying to do some fancy footwork while his teammates will be corralling up onto Pop Dog. Spots out. Dispenser actually still wins the duel right there. Now he knows where Adrian is. He's going to be putting a Molotov there to flush him out, possibly. Adrian is missing his shots and almost actually allows Rekka, or rather Supersys, to get that 3K.
It's now 10-12 in favor of Mineski, and wow, this is starting to be a close fight. I'm already edging near the monitor right now from this intense game.
Yeah, so again, for you who are asking, The first map was actually in favor of Rekka Esports. They won it 1-0 against Mineski. And yeah.
1-0 against Mineski. And X-Grid actually takes down Dubstep. It's a 5v4 situation. Mana bandage
with
down.
A very aggressive peek in near Electric Box, and he gets the kill alongside with Dispenser. And now they find Frost Misty coming out of Pop Dog and recheck just too damn on point. Gets another kill as well. Russo gonna be coming out of Pop Dog himself to maybe challenge this wall of Mineski, but not gonna be enough. And Esports Bentet, Rekka Bentet, right on for the backstab. He's gonna smoke in his entrance right there. But Retrack was waiting at the edge of the train, and he will get that one. Look at this, Mineski are starting to steamroll this round, and I think Rekka Esports are going to be forced to go into either a force buy or an eco round here.
Well, I think we're going to find out in just a few seconds. No, it's just going to be a full-on eco for Rekka. Oh, wait. They got the Tech Nines. Three Tech Nines, a Deagle, a couple of Deagles. I don't know. We'll see how they're going to do this. And look at the train that's happening right now for Rekka. I think this is going to be a full-on B-take, and Gi is the only person there. And Frost Misty spots out Gi, and they are still taking their time. They don't want to give out their position just yet. They don't want
They're baiting out the rotation of Mineski so that they can actually have a more free A site here. Yeah, I mean, it's a standard play that I've seen happen from other more experienced PH teams. And it works on some degree. But you can see that Rekka Esports kind of know what's up, so, or rather Mineski kind of knows what's up, so they're having some people look at Pop Dog.
Yeah, the rotation is still going here for Mineski. They're keeping their calm. They know that Rekka is up to something. I mean, considering the fact that I'm pretty sure they know that Rekka doesn't have enough money to work with here.
Yes. And now Rekka Esports with 40 seconds left on the clock. They're setting up their smokes. They're setting up their flashes. Or sorry, they're just the smoke. And there's G.
G with a spray down!
Triple mow down, and he takes down three members of Rekka in the blink of an eye. Helped by his teammates, Bentet is looking for the 1Ds. He has been so good with these taps, but not gonna be enough. Supers is finally shutting him down. But will Supersys actually go for the plant, or will he go for the 2v1? Actually, he can. He has the armor for this, but he's just gonna go for... What? Dispenser doesn't hit the shot, though. That could have actually been Dispenser eating the dust there, but he still gets the kill.
I mean, at this point, Rekka just needs the extra money, so that bomb plant, that's gonna be a huge factor for them. But damn.
Lots of comments on Mineski. They have that
mindset.
That snowball, that negative snowball, but not all, you know, not really.
Yeah.
It's just that some of the teams here kind of spot out how they play, and in the strategy of, well, Rekka is actually looking to be more effective than Mineski's.
Yeah. And for those asking, the people that won the first game, it was Rekka Esports, a 16-14 scoreline on Cobblestone. This is the second map in this best of three series of the Shootout Season 3, presented by MixBot.
Yeah, can't forget MixBot. Awesome, awesome people for helping us with a cheat-free server.
Environment, yeah.
Yes, cheat-free environment.
No vacations here, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, that's our Retract gonna go for the double kill for getting taken down by Frost Misty. He's now down to a 3v3 situation. Still anybody's ball game. Supersys takes down Dispenser, and Dubstep taking down Supersys. It's just Frost Misty on his own, and Dubstep is gonna be able to wipe it out clean, and he's gonna go for the easy defuse.
And Mineski, they're gonna...
they're struggling.
They're gonna be only one round away from pushing this into a game 3.
Yeah, just one
Imagine
more round.
That.
Mineski is now on match point. Oh wow, this is pretty intense. Will Rekka Esports be able to force an overtime, or will Mineski take the second game and force out a game 3? One, press 1 if Rekka's gonna go for an overtime. Press 2. If Mineski is going to seal the deal.
Get to game 3.
And go to game 3, yes. Thank you for correcting me there.
Yeah.
Yeah, right now Mineski is playing it safe. They don't want to lose this round. They lose this round, Erica Esports will have the momentum. I don't think I'm sorry about that. That was almost getting a shot there. Yeah, as I was saying, they don't think that
he missed his second shot too.
Money to work with him the next round, but Dubstep finally gets a kill on Rizzo. Retract takes down Accurate, and it's down quickly, down to a 3v3 situation. I think that a 2v3 situation is just Benta on himself going in for the backstab. Benta takes down Dispenser.
And if someone can clutch this, it could only be Benta. Can he keep his team alive, or will Mineski push this into Game 3, go into Mirage, and prove all the viewers wrong?
It's going to be a 1v1 situation right now between Retract and Benta. The bomb has been dropped.
He knows where Retract is right now, so he can go for the bomb plant. He's going to go for B-Slide to go for a safer plant here. 100 HP, or almost full HP on both of these guys. And at the same time, Retract does have that defuse kit. So right now, Benta is playing for broke here. He does have a nade and the AK-47, but well, of course this is the last round already. His team needs to come back, push it to 5 rounds, and get into overtime.
Yeah, and Rekka,
look at this, everybody's just spouting energy
gap. Beat energy gap. But yeah, let's have a look at Retract there. Oh, he actually sees Benta, and this is going to be game. Beautiful clutch there by Retract.
Oh,
he's down to 1 HP if he falls down that train. It's going to be... Wow. That would have been funny if Retract fell from the train. He took... Oh, I got to look at the ladder. Take it. Take care.
Yeah. Well, Retract is, a seasoned veteran, so...
He knows.
Yes, he has some injuries. He has to go down to the ladder safely. Yeah.